Hey everybody, approximately 1 year ago, I did my first freelancing job and it was literally a life-changing moment for me because I got to know so much and I learned so many things from there, and also I had an amazing experience working at that freelancing job. So how did I do all this? Which platform did I use? How much did I earn through this? How much work did I did? Which domain did I choose? Everything in detail I will tell you in this video. So do watch this video till the end. Let's get started. So talking about which platform did I use? So I was using Fiverr because I have seen many platforms like Fiverr, Freelancer, Upwork, all these platforms. I thought that Fiverr would be the best one because here you don't have to search for the clients. The clients automatically come and search for the best freelancers out there. So let me start the journey from the start. It was January of 2022 and I wanted to learn a new skill, that is Android development. So I started with the Android development basics, and then within 3 months I covered most of the part of it. So I thought that I was ready for freelancing and I searched for the jobs online. I was not able to find any because overall the environment was very competitive and there were lots of players who had got higher ratings than me. So I was not able to compete with those who have actually delivered their services. And I was completely new in this market. So after learning Android development for 3 months, I started with freelancing. I went to fiverr.com, created my first gig there, and the gig was about doing an Android development for approximately 7,000 for an app. So it was about the price range that everyone was charging. There was no differentiator in me, and also I had no ratings. So if you search for Android development in fiverr.com, you would not be able to see my profile because I had no ratings, and because of that Fiverr won't boost me on their website. So next, I wanted some ratings and to do actual projects on Fiverr. But after making my gig, nothing happened. I also tried on freelancer.com and Upwork. Nothing happened actually there too. But after a month, I got an email, and it was that a payments company from New Delhi wanted to make an app. They already had an app in another language. They wanted to make a native app and they wanted to use Kotlin or Java for it. So I was ready with my skills for that. I told that I would be able to develop this app and it was all good. After that, we talked about the pricing. They asked me how much would I charge for this. I had no idea about what were the charges going on in the market. So I quickly searched on Google. I went to various gigs on Fiverr and I came up that I would charge approximately 4,500 for this. I know this amount is actually very low for an app development, but I didn't have any experience with this, so I thought it was fair enough for me. So I told him, he immediately agreed with the amount, and then the contract was started. He told me to develop this app within 20 days and they also had their backend, so I was getting APIs from them. We also had a group to coordinate with the backend developers, and the people in that company were literally very good. They talked to me properly. They also had proper systems management, and the things I required, they immediately provided to me. Like the images that I required, the designing styles, everything they provided to me very quickly. So after 2 days, I talked to them on a call because I was still learning Android and I had not mastered it. So I was not very confident with the skills of making many API calls to the server. I thought that the app would crash or it would not work. So I told the same thing to my client, and he told me that it would be great if I just make the front end of the app and take the half of the payment. So I thought that it would be good. I would just make the UI of the app, and even by making the UI, I would receive half of the payment. So it was win-win for both of us. And then I was ready with the UI within 3 days. So after 3 days, I submitted the UI, completed the project and received my amount. And during this whole process, I learned that even if we think that we have acquired some skills, but it is not true. There is a lot more to understand, lot more to know. I didn't need to make API calls, didn't need services, what are background services, how to show notifications. All these things I have learned after completing the freelancing project. And this was really an eye-opener for me for such things. This was my first that I have done until now, and I earned total of 2,250 rupees per day by doing just the work 3 days. I think this is good for a 17-year-old to do this. Actually, good to start with something. This was the first time when I had earned some money, and I actually felt really very good doing this because I have seen students of my age in the college who do not do anything and they just keep on scrolling the reels and watching videos on YouTube. They never try doing stuff. They never attempt to fail because they are afraid of doing it. They are afraid of failing. But actually, until we fail, we cannot learn. So to learn, to keep on growing, we have to keep on failing. And this was one of them. And by doing this, I learned that acquiring only the basics of the skill won't work. You have to acquire the complete skill along with the basics and the advanced things that are currently working in the market. Because in field of technology, updates keep on rolling out every day and you have to keep up with these new updates. And learning is not actually that happens in 1 or 2 days. It's an ongoing process that keeps on continuing every day. Thank you so much for watching this. I hope you understood something that was really insightful for you. If you loved this video, give it a like, subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for watching this, and I'll see you in the next one.